Hi guys, my name is Prapon Chopakapan, but you can call me C. Since I was a kid, I always loved drawing and sketching. In the past year, after I entered college, I found a love in character design, and I often do it as a hobby in my free time to have fun and relax. So in this video, we're going to talk about character design and how to create one. What is a character design? Character design refers to the process of creating character for animated film, comic, TV, toys, and publication. Character design in film and games is a form of concept art that involves visually defining a character, physical appearance, personality, behavior, and aesthetic. It is more than just a drawing, since a character plays an essential role in telling a story. For today, I will design a character that is inspired from Ghibli film like Kiki Delivery Service and Ponyo on the Cliff, because I like the theme of magic and I want to combine it with the ocean creature to create something new and interesting. For this character, I set it in a fantasy world setting of my own, inspired from the beautiful scenery of Ghibli film that is full of wonder in nature and magical feeling around them. I want to create a design that can tell the story of this young wizard. He is a young apprentice witch that lives under the vast blue ocean. Now, when we have the story of the character that we are going to design, it is time to take a look at the element of good character design. So, what makes a character interesting and memorable? What sets one character apart from others? Good character design starts with three important elements. 1. A silhouette. A silhouette shows the outline of a character, shape, and excludes interior detail, like facial feature and color. By using what's called shape language, you can create meaning through the line, curve, and angle that make up a character silhouette. This choice can mean the difference between a character that looks soft and cuddly and one that looks menacing and dangerous. For my character, I want him to be cute and friendly, so I will pick the silhouette that is more round and square with some pointy triangle shape from the witch hat to tell the audience that he is a wizard. I want his personality to be like an adventurer with a playful and cheerful vibe. After we got the silhouette, we move on to the sketching part, which is the most fun part of the drawing. I really enjoy drawing this in a fantasy world as it fulfills my childhood and makes the dream come alive. So, how does character design become my hobby? When I create a character, I try to imagine myself as that character. I start to think about who they are, what their name, when they were born, and what the world they live in look like. I love watching movies and imagine myself as a protagonist or the character that lives inside a story. Next, the third part is all about a color and color palette. So, it refers to the designer use of different color to make a color character unique. By using color theory, you can choose color for character effectively and evoke emotion in the audience. For example, red can convey a character passion or intensity, while green can convey a connection to nature or serenity. For my character, I will use teal, blue, and red, also white, to focus on the aquatic theme and add some contrast to his palette with the red from coral and some bright color to add a variety of color in his design. Also, I got inspired from the jellyfish and the sea creature that I'm using as a reference. One element that can be overlooked is exaggeration, which refers to making some of a character feature more prominent than others, such as by enlarging the eyes or having the character make dynamic gesture. Depending on what you exaggerate, you can make a character appear comical, beautiful, evil, heroic, and more. For my little hero, I exaggerate his hat and the pendant on his chest to make him look like a small child that is wearing his parent hat. So everything he wears is from his family, both father and mother,
it looks bigger and gives off a cozy vibe. After I finish setting the color for him, I move on to the last part, which is rendering and polishing the character. Since we don't have much time, I will only focus on making him look good as much as possible, and I hope you enjoy watching this. Thank you.